Note, the following video depicts a specific configuration of the tablet. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the tablet. Important: the processor, memory, WLAN plus Bluetooth, and eMMC storage card are all embedded on the system board. If any of these components fail and require replacement, the entire system board must be replaced. The tablet provides units with 32GB, 64GB, and 128GB eMMC modules soldered onto the system board. In addition, the system board contains the Windows DPK. If you are replacing the system board, be sure to order the board that contains the correct storage capacity and Windows OS version. Important: the system boards are not localized. If the system board is replaced, the service technician must also reinstall the operating system. Before you begin, remove the back cover and wireless WAN module if installed. Removal. Important: the SD card and nano SIM card trays must be removed before attempting to remove the system board. Insert a small straightened paper clip into the nano SIM card tray access hole. Press in gently only until the nano SIM card tray is ejected. Remove the nano SIM card tray from the tablet. The SD card tray is removed in the same manner. Important: make careful note of the routing of all cables for later replacement. Remove the two 1.2mm P0 Phillips head screws that secure the Pogo connector bracket to the system board. Remove the Pogo connector bracket from its position on the Pogo connector. Disconnect the Pogo connector cable from its connector on the system board. Important: make careful note of which terminal the wireless LAN antenna cables are connected to on the system board for later replacement. Carefully disconnect the wireless LAN antenna cables from the system board by grasping the connectors with a small pair of needle-nose pliers or tweezers. Caution: use care when disconnecting the wireless LAN antenna cables from the system board. A damaged cable or connector can degrade tablet performance. Remove the main wireless LAN antenna cable from the routing clips on the system board. Remove the 2mm P0 Phillips head screw that secures the touchscreen ribbon cable to the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchscreen ZIF connector and disconnect the touchscreen ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Carefully disconnect the vibrator motor cable from its connector on the system board. Carefully disconnect the right speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the button microphone ZIF connector and disconnect the button microphone ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the two 1.2mm P0 Phillips head screws that secured the display panel cable bracket to the system board. Remove the display panel cable bracket from its position on the display panel cable connector. Disconnect the display panel cable from its connector on the system board. Remove the metallic shielding that covers both webcam ZIF connectors on the system board. Remove the retention tape that covers both webcam ZIF connectors on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the rear-facing webcam ZIF connector and disconnect the rear-facing webcam ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the front-facing webcam ZIF connector and disconnect the front-facing webcam ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the audio board ZIF connector and disconnect the audio board ribbon cable from the audio board. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the four 2mm P0 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the display panel assembly. Remove the 3mm P0 Phillips head screw that secures the system board to the display panel assembly. Peel back the tape that secures the aux wireless WAN antenna cable to the system board. Carefully lift the left edge of the system board and at an angle, remove the USB port from the cutout in the display panel assembly. Remove the system board. Replacement. Important. The audio board is paired with the system board. The audio board must be replaced every time the system board is replaced and is provided in the system board spare kit. When the audio board and system board are replaced together, reflashing of the TXE region in SPI ROM is not necessary. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board. Audio board ribbon cable. Tow the USB port on the system board into the cutout in the display panel assembly and lower the system board into position. Caution! Ensure that all the cables are free from being pinched between the system board and display panel assembly. Replace the 3mm P0 Phillips head screw that secures the system board to the display panel assembly. Replace the four 2mm P0 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the display panel assembly. Insert the audio board ribbon cable into the audio board ZIF connector on the audio board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the front-facing webcam ribbon cable into the front-facing webcam ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the rear-facing webcam ribbon cable into the rear-facing webcam ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Replace the retention tape that covers both the webcam ZIF connectors on the system board. Replace the metallic shielding that covers both of the webcam ZIF connectors to the system board. Connect the display panel cable onto its connector on the system board. Place the display panel cable bracket into position on the display panel cable connector. Replace the two 1.2mm P0 Phillips head screws that secure the display panel cable bracket to the system board. Insert the button microphone ribbon cable into the button microphone ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Connect the right speaker cable into its connector on the system board. Connect the vibrator motor cable into its connector on the system board. Route the vibrator motor cable under the routing tab on the right speaker. Insert the touchscreen cable into the touchscreen ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Replace the 2mm P0 Phillips head screw that secures the touchscreen cable to the system board. Route the main wireless LAN antenna cable through the routing clips on the system board. Reconnect the wireless LAN antenna cables to the system board. Caution: use care when connecting the wireless LAN antenna cables to the system board. A damaged cable or connector can degrade tablet performance. Connect the Pogo connector cable into its connector on the system board. Place the Pogo connector bracket into position on the Pogo connector. Replace the two 1.2mm P0 Phillips head screws that secure the Pogo connector bracket to the system board. Insert the nano SIM card tray into the nano SIM card slot and press the nano SIM card tray in until it is flush with the display panel assembly. The SD card tray is replaced in the same manner. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the tablet, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings, injecting Microsoft Windows 8 digital product keys.